welcome to Gate Academy. And today we'll be starting the topic alum. Like in the previous lecture, we have studied the various coagulants, hydrated copperas, chlorinated copperas, sodium aluminate and lye. But today we'll be focusing on alum because maximum questions are being asked on these topics. If a question on coagulant will be asked, definitely it will be asked from the alum part. Now, what is the chemical formula of alum? The chemical formula is given by Al2SO4 thrice dot 18H2. This is the chemical formula of alum. Now, what we will be studying in this is, see, one thing which you have to know about this alum is it requires alkalinity, means alum requires alkalinity in water. Like we studied for the hydrated copperas, it also requires alkalinity. Similarly, alum requires alkalinity and does not work in acidic pH So, in case if the water is not alkaline, in this case what we will add, in that case we will add lime to it. Lime imparts alkalinity to water. So, addition of lime will be there. Addition of lime for providing alkalinity. Now, in today's lecture, what all things we will be covering is, I'll draw the reactions or I'll write the reactions of alum with the temporary hardness calcium hydrogen carbonate, and we'll get the products. What are the products which are obtained? Then we can calculate how much amount of alum, how much amount of other substances are required for providing coagulant in water. So let's start. Like I'll tell you, if this is Al2SO4 thrice dot 18H2, which is alum, when we made it to react with calcium hydrogen carbonate, which is a temporary hardness, we have discussed in earlier lectures, calcium hydrogen carbonate, when it reacts, it leads to the formation of aluminium hydroxide plus calcium sulfate plus carbon dioxide and water. So, this is the reaction which happens. This is alum. When it reacts with bicarbonate alkalinity, it could have been magnesium also here. So, when it reacts with bicarbonate alkalinity, it leads to the formation of, what are the compounds it reacts with? It leads to the formation of aluminium hydroxide, which is a flock. Then it leads to the formation of calcium sulfate, which imparts permanent hardness to water. We have already studied temporary hardness and permanent hardness. So, calcium sulfate, which imparts permanent hardness to water. Now, what does carbon dioxide do? It causes corrosion of pipelines. And the water. So, you can see here that when alum reacts with bicarbonate alkalinity, we get the following products. Now, from numerical point of view, what all things we have to see, we'll proceed in a manner like calcium hydrogen carbonate. How we get calcium hydrogen carbonate? When calcium carbonate reacts with water, it leads to the formation of calcium hydrogen carbonate. Now, For balancing this reaction, we can add three times of calcium carbonate and three times of calcium hydrogen carbonate. We can see that here this three times of calcium hydrogen carbonate bicarbonate alkanity is obtained when we add water to calcium carbonate. Now, what we can conclude from here, first from this equation, that 1 mole of bicarbonate alkanity, or we can say 1 mole of alum, because here no number is there, so we will consider it as 1. So, 1 mole. Mole you have understood because you have studied in the initial classes in your 11th and 12th, like how we calculate moles, it's the given mass upon the molecular mass will give us the number of moles. So, however, here no numerical value is being given, so we will take it as 1 mole. 1 mole of alum gives 3 mole of bicarbonate alkanity, gives 3 mole of bicarbonate alkanity. Similarly, we have seen 1 mole of alum gives 3 moles of bicarbonate alkanity. Similarly, 3 moles of bicarbonate alkalinity gives 3 moles of calcium carbonate. We can write 3 moles of calcium carbonate gives 3 moles of bicarbonate alkalinity. I hope you are clear with these two equations which I am making. This is first equation, this is second equation. Now, when we combine these two equations, or what is the inference which we get from these two equations, is that, see, 1 mole of alum gives 3 moles of bicarbonate alkanity. Similarly, 3 moles of calcium carbonate gives 3 moles of bicarbonate alkanity. In this, the 3 moles of bicarbonate alkanity is common. So, what we can infer is 1 mole of alum gives 3 moles of calcium carbonate. Fine. So, we can write it here. 1 mole of alum gives 3 moles of alkanity as calcium carbonate, as calcium carbonate. This is the first statement which we infer. See, this is not being asked, but the calculation which we will be doing, this is being asked in the numerical problems, means the final result which you will be getting, it will be asked. So, instead of mugging up, it's better that you should understand, so that you can solve the problem even though if you are not recalling the formulas, fine. So, what happens is, we can see the molecular weight, while calculating the molecular weight of alum, it comes out to be 66666 grams. Fine, this is the molecular weight of alum. This leads to the formation of 3 moles of calcium hydrogen carbonate. So, what will be the molecular formula of the calcium hydrogen carbonate will be 162 grams. We can calculate 3 into 20 is the 40 is the molecular weight of calcium hydrogen 1, carbon 12 and oxygen 16. So, on doing this, we will get 3 times of 162 grams. This happens when alum, this is the molecular weight of alum, and 1 mole is there. So, 1 into 666 grams. Similarly, this is calcium hydrogen carbonate thrice. We come to know this. Similarly, the next reaction, which is the 3 times of calcium carbonate, which we have written already, with water, gives 3 times of calcium hydrogen carbonate. So, what is the molecular formula here? Calcium carbonate, the molecular formula is 3 into 100. 100 is the molecular weight. Fine. And here it comes to be 3 into 162. Now, from here you got 666 grams of alum leads to the formation of 3 into 162 grams of bicarbonate alkanity. Similarly, here 3 into 100 grams of calcium carbonate leads to the formation of 3 into 162 grams of bicarbonate alkanity. From these two, what you can calculate is 666 grams of alum leads to the formation of 3 into 100 grams of alkanity. As calcium carbonate. अगर हमें 666 grams का पता है तो हम 1 ग्राम का निकाल सकते हैं. सी इफ आई कन्वर्ट दिस ग्राम्स इनटू मिलीग्राम्स एंड हियर आल्सो ग्राम्स इनटू मिलीग्राम्स, सो व्हेन आई मल्टीप्लाई इट बाय 1000, सो दैट विल गेट कैंसल आउट. सो व्हाट आई विल राइट इट 1 mg per liter. इंस्टेड ऑफ राइटिंग आई कन्वर्टेड द ग्राम्स इनटू मिलीग्राम्स एंड आई रूट डिवाइडेड बाय लीटर. आई विल बी कंसिडरिंग 1 liter ऑफ वाटर. सो 1 mg per liter ऑफ एलम leads to the formation of 3 into 100 upon 666 mg per liter of alkanity as calcium carbonate. So on solving this you will get as 0.5 mg per liter of alkanity as calcium carbonate. So what we'll infer from this is 1 mg per liter of filter alum dosage requires an alkanity of 0.45 mg per liter 0.45 mg per liter in the form of calcium carbonate. This is the most important thing which you have to remember. What is the use of it? I'll tell you. See, initially I told you that the filter alum requires alkanity, then only it can function. It doesn't function in acidic water. So in case if a water doesn't contain alkanity in it, so for every 1 mg of alum which we are adding in 1 liter of water, we have to add alkalinity of 0.45 mg in 1 liter of water in the form of calcium carbonate. Questions will be asked. We'll be dealing with the questions after I'll complete this topic for filter alums. But before that, what you have to understand is we have been given 1 mg requires 0.45 mg. So how much alum will be required, or how much alkalinity is required for 2 mld of water, for 5 mld of water? These sort of questions comes. So you don't have to derive this. This I told you so that you will understand instead of mugging up how this relation came. So basically you have to remember this while solving the questions. Now we completed the part of calcium carbonate. Now calcium carbonate also leads to the dissociation of calcium oxide plus carbon dioxide. This is the chemical reaction for calcium carbonate. The molecular weight of calcium carbonate is 100, while for calcium oxide it is 56, 40 for calcium and 16 for oxygen. So in total it makes 56. Now we know that 100 grams of calcium carbonate leads to the formation of 56 grams of calcium oxide. What we'll write? 100 grams of calcium carbonate leads to 56 grams of calcium oxide. Similarly, what we can do is we can write it instead of 100 grams, we can write it as 100 mg of calcium carbonate. And here we can write 56 mg of calcium oxide. Now dividing it by 1 liter of water, we are asking in 1 liter of water, so 100 mg per liter of calcium carbonate leads to 56 mg per liter of calcium oxide. That is, calcium oxide is known as quicklime. So 1 mg per liter of calcium carbonate leads to 56 divided by 100 mg per liter of calcium oxide. So what we can say that 1 mg per liter of calcium carbonate leads to 0.56 mg per liter of calcium oxide. 0.56 mg per liter of calcium oxide. I'll write it here. One mg per liter of calcium carbonate requires an addition of 0.56 mg per liter of calcium oxide. Fine, this also you have to remember. अगर हमारे पास 1 mg कैल्शियम कार्बोनेट है 1 लीटर ऑफ वाटर में और हमको उसमें एल्कनेटिक कैल्शियम ऑक्साइड की ज़रूरत है तो उसमें हम 1 mg ऑफ कैल्शियम कार्बोनेट के लिए 0.56 mg ऑफ कैल्शियम ऑक्साइड क्विक लाइम डालते हैं पानी में ताकि कि कैल्शियम कार्बोनेट फॉर्म हो सके. Fine, these are interrelated questions. I'll tell you the questions. This is very important. First, you have to learn that 1 mg per liter of filter alum dosage requires an alkalinity of 0.45 mg per liter in the form of calcium carbonate. Similarly, how is calcium carbonate dependent upon? It depends upon calcium oxide and carbon dioxide. एक complex compound को दो simple compounds मिलके form करते हैं. तो अगर हमको बोला गया alum के लिए हमको bicarbonate alkalinity चाहिए तो bicarbonate alkalinity के लिए हमको क्या चाहिए? कैल्शियम कार्बोनेट चाहिए और कैल्शियम कार्बोनेट के लिए क्या चाहिए? हमको कैल्शियम ऑक्साइड चाहिए. सो यू हैव टू इंटरलिंक एंड स्टडी. सी, इट्स नॉट एट ऑल डिफिकल्ट. द थिंग इज, अगर आप कॉन्सेप्ट वाइज जानोगे कि इसके बाद ये कैसे आया, देन यू विल अंडरस्टैंड इट इन अ बेटर मैनर. सो दिस इज द सेकेंड वन. 1 mg पर लीटर ऑफ कैल्शियम कार्बोनेट रिक्वायर्स एन एडिशन ऑफ 0.56 mg पर लीटर ऑफ कैल्शियम ऑक्साइड. यू हैव टू लर्न दिस. नाउ वट वील बी डूइंग इज, वील बी स्टार्टिंग द थर्ड वन. That is, alum reacts with bicarbonate alkalinity leads to the formation of flock. So what we'll write it here as 666 gram of filter alum leads to formation of, what is the molecular weight of aluminium hydroxide? It is 78. Fine. So leads to the formation of 78 grams of flock. If I say flock, it means aluminium hydroxide only in case of filter alums. So now I'll write it directly for you to understand. We have already seen that if we multiply by 10 raised to power 3 on both the sides, it will be converted to milligrams. That will get cancelled out, and we'll divide it for, we'll take out the value for 1 liter of water. So 1 mg per liter of filter alum will lead to 2 × 78 divided by 666 mg per liter of aluminium hydroxide. So on calculating this, we'll get the value as 0.23 mg per liter. So what we'll infer from this is 1 mg per liter of filter alum generates 1 flock of aluminium hydroxide of 0.23 mg per liter. इसका मतलब ये होता है, अगर आप 1 mg फिल्टर एलम का डालते हो 1 लीटर पानी में, तो आपको 0.23 mg का फ्लॉक मिलेगा। ठीक है, तो अभी हमने क्या क्या कंप्लीट कर लिया? एल्यूमिनियम हाइड्रोक्साइड कंप्लीट कर लिया, कैल्शियम कार्बोनेट कंप्लीट कर लिया, कैल्शियम ऑक्साइड कंप्लीट कर लिया। नाउ वी विल बी मूविंग टू कैल्शियम सल्फेट। नाउ वी विल सी दैट एलम रिएक्ट्स टू फॉर्म परमानेंट हार्डनेस। सो व्हाट वी विल राइट इज 1 × 666 grams of filter alum generates how much? 3 is the number of moles and the molecular weight of calcium sulfate is 136 grams. So 136 grams of calcium sulfate, that is the permanent hardness. So 1 mg per liter of filter alum will lead to the formation of how much? 3 × 136 divided by 666. So this will lead to 0.613 mg per liter of calcium sulfate. So from this also we got a relation that 1 mg per liter of filter alum generates 0.613 mg per liter of permanent hardness in the form of calcium sulfate. किसके form में generate करता है? calcium sulfate के। तो अभी तक हमने चार relations पढ़ लिया है, last one is the carbon dioxide. So what we see is 1 mole of filter alum leads to the formation of 6 moles of carbon dioxide. So what we'll see is 1 mole, that is 1 × 666 grams of filter alum leads to the formation of, what is the molecular weight of carbon dioxide? It is 44 grams. So leads to the formation or liberates 6 moles of carbon dioxide. So 1 mg per liter of filter alum will lead to how much generation or how much liberation of carbon dioxide? This will lead to 6 × 44 divided by 666. So on solving this, we'll get the value as 0.396 mg per liter of carbon dioxide. Fine. So what we'll write it here as 1 mg per liter of filter alum liberates 0.396 mg per liter of carbon dioxide. So we have got all the 5 relations. This we'll be using it just now only. We'll be solving numerical. Then you can get a clear picture why we calculated this. What was the reason for calculating this? Let us take a quick revision for this first. What we saw first, 1 mg per liter of filter alum doses requires an alkinity, because I told you it functions only in an alkaline water, requires an alkinity of 0.45 mg per liter in the form of calcium carbonate. After that, what we did was we splitted calcium carbonate into calcium oxide and carbon dioxide. So what we got, that 1 mg per liter of calcium carbonate requires an addition of 0.56 mg per liter of calcium oxide, that is quicklime. If it would be given you quicklime, it means calcium oxide only. Fine. In the questions, if they wouldn't have mentioned you calcium oxide and they would have written quicklime, so it means CaO only. After that, what we saw that the alum addition generates flog, that is aluminium hydroxide. So we calculated 1 mg per liter of filter alum generates a flog of 0.23 mg per liter in the form of aluminium hydroxide. Third we got was permanent hardness in the form of calcium carbonate. What we saw that 1 mg per liter of alum generates 0.613 mg per liter of permanent hardness in the form of calcium carbonate. And last was the liberation of carbon dioxide. So we saw that 1 mg per liter of filter alum liberates 0.396 mg per liter of carbon dioxide. See, you have to remember this, that how much is the quantity which is generated or which is liberated. But the thing is, in case you are not remembering it, you can calculate it from this formula, provided you have to know this reaction, with the help of which you can calculate the amount of doses required. So now we will be solving numerical so that you can get a clear picture why we started it. Moving on to the questions, let's see the first question regarding alum. The question is, a water treatment plant treating 10 mld of water requires 20 mg per liter of alum dosage. The water has 6 mg per liter of alkalinity as calcium carbonate. What we have to find is the alkalinity requirement matching the filter alum in kg. Secondly, we have been required the quantity of quicklime required per annum shall be. So what we have to do, it has already given that 6 mg per liter of alkalinity is present in the form of calcium carbonate, and we have been given as 10 mld per liter of water and the alum dosage as 20 mg per liter. I told you one thing regarding whenever it is asked alkalinity in the form of calcium carbonate. What we studied was 1 mg of filter alum dosage requires 0.5 mg per liter of alkalinity in the form of calcium carbonate. So by seeing the questions what is given, we can write 1 mg per liter of alum requires 0.45 mg per liter of alkalinity in the form of calcium carbonate. Now in question it has given that what is the quantity of alum? 20 mg per liter. So what will be the amount of alkalinity generated? 20 mg per liter of alum will require 20 into 0.45 mg per liter of alkalinity, we'll add of alkalinity in the form of calcium carbonate. So on solving this, we'll get it as 9 mg per liter of alkalinity as calcium carbonate. अब ये तो हमको पता चला कि जब हमने एक लीटर में 20 mg का alum डाला तो हमको 9 mg per liter की alkalinity मिली. तो अगर टोटल क्वांटिटी 10 mld है तो कितनी अमाउंट ऑफ एल्किनिटी ज़रूरी होगी. तो हम लोग इसको 10 से मल्टीप्लाई कर देंगे 10 mld ऑफ वाटर से. तो हमको एक लीटर के लिए अगर मिल गया तो 10 mld के लिए हम निकाल सकते हैं. सो व्हाट विल राइट फॉर एंटायर वाटर एल्किनिटी रिक्वायर्ड इज, this will be equal to 9 mg per liter into 10 into 10 raised to power 6 liters per day. I told you that whenever you solve environmental questions, any questions of environmental engineering, it's better if you write the unit corresponding to it. So you will know what are the units which are being cancelled down, what are the units which has to be converted. So this liter and liter will get cancelled out. 1 kg is equal to 10 raised to power 6 mg. So on solving this, we will get it as 90 kg per day. So your answer will be, the alkalinity required matching the filter alum in kg shall be 90 kg per day. Now comes the second question, the quantity of quicklime required per annum shall be. Quicklime, I told you, this is calcium oxide. Now what is there? जब अगर हमारे किसी भी वाटर की क्वांटिटी में एल्किनिटी डिजायर्ड अमाउंट में प्रेजेंट नहीं है तो फिल्टर एलम एफिशिएंटली वर्क नहीं कर पाता है, इसीलिए हम उसमें कैल्शियम ऑक्साइड डालते हैं ताकि एल्किनिटी प्रोड्यूस हो। ऑलरेडी हमको क्वेश्चन में दिया हुआ है कि 6 mg/L ऑफ एल्किनिटी प्रेजेंट है, पर हमारी रिक्वायरमेंट कितनी थी? अगर 20 mg/L ऑफ एलम डोज हम प्रोवाइड कर रहे हैं एज मेंशन इन द क्वेश्चन, तो हमारी रिक्वायरमेंट थी एल्किनिटी की 9 mg/L, पर उस वाटर में 6 mg/L की एल्किनिटी प्रेजेंट है। मींस हमको एडिशनल एल्किनिटी कितनी रिक्वायर्ड है? 9 - 6। सो फॉर द सेकेंड पार्ट, एडिशनल एल्किनिटी रिक्वायर्ड दिस इज 9 - 6 mg/L, सो दिस विल गिव यू 3 mg/L ऑफ एल्किनिटी इज रिक्वायर्ड एज कैल्शियम कार्बोनेट ऑफ एल्किनिटी इन द फॉर्म ऑफ कैल्शियम कार्बोनेट इज रिक्वायर्ड। फाइन, नाउ हाउ वी गेट दिस कैल्शियम कार्बोनेट? दिस कैल्शियम कार्बोनेट एल्किनिटी विच इज फुलफिल्ड बाय कैल्शियम ऑक्साइड। नाउ what we have seen, the relation I told you earlier was that 1 mg/L of calcium carbonate requires an addition of 0.456 mg/L of calcium oxide, that is quicklime. So we'll be using this relation to get the amount of quicklime required. So we'll write 1 mg/L of alkalinity as calcium carbonate requires 0.456 mg/L of calcium oxide. Fine, so we will be needing 3 mg/L. 3 mg/L of alkalinity as calcium carbonate will require how much? 0.56 into 3 mg/L. On solving this, we'll get 1.68 mg/L of calcium oxide. This amount is required for 3 mg/L. We required 1.68 mg/L of calcium oxide. But we have to treat the entire water, that is 10 mld of water. So what we'll write is, for entire water, calcium oxide required, or we can say quick lime required, is 1 liter में 1.68 mg, तो 10 mld में कितना होगा? 10 × 10⁶ liters per day × 1.68 mg/L. On solving this, we'll get it as 16.8 kg/day. पर क्वेश्चन में उसने क्या पूछा है? द क्वांटिटी ऑफ क्विक लाइम रिक्वायर्ड पर एनम पूछा हुआ उसने, मतलब एक साल में आपको कितनी रिक्वायरमेंट है। अगर यहाँ पे इसने पर एनम नहीं दिया होता तो आंसर वुड बी इंटायर वाटर के लिए हमको 16.8 kg/day रिक्वायर्ड है, बट यहाँ पर उसने हमसे पूछा है पर एनम, सो वी मल्टीप्लाई दिस बाय 365 days। सो क्वांटिटी ऑफ लाइम, I'll write it here only, quantity of lime required per annum will be 16.8 kg/day into the number of days, that is 365 days. So on solving this, we'll get it as 6132 kgs, which will be your answer. They'll give you here that you have to substitute in kg. So you will get it here as 6132 kg of quick lime is required for treating 10 mld of water. So I hope this question is very much clear to you. In this we calculated the amount of quick lime and we also calculated the amount of alkalinity in the form of calcium carbonate. Moving on to the second question, let's see what's the question. Given the dosage of alum as 14 ppm, determine the quantity of alum required to treat 12 mld of water. Also, determine the amount of carbon dioxide gas which will be released per liter of water treated. So, we have to find here two things. First, the total quantity of alum required. Secondly, we have to find the amount of carbon dioxide gas liberated. So, we can see first, let's see the first answer, what will be the solution for it. 14 ppm. I told you that 1 ppm is equal to 1 mg per liter. So, 14 ppm means 14 mg per liter. Now, we see that in the question, total quantity of water which is given to us as total quantity of water which is given to us is 12 mld, that is 12 into 10 raised to power 6 liters per day, and the dose of alum which is given to us is 14 ppm. Dosage of alum is given to us as 14 ppm, that is 14 mg per liter. So, for entire water, for 1 liter of water we have been required the dosage of 14 mg. Similarly, for the whole 12 mld of water, we will be requiring 14 into the 12 mld of water. That is the alum dosage. For entire water, alum dosage will be, अगर हमको 1 लीटर का पता है कि 14 mg लगता है तो 12 into 10 raise to power 6 liters में कितना लगेगा? We'll simply multiply it 12 mg per liter into 12 into 10 raise to power 6 liters per day. Liter and liter will get cancelled out. 1 kg is equal to 10 raise to power 6 mg. On solving this, we'll get it as 168 kg per day. So your first answer will be the total quantity of alum required for treating the water is 168 kg per day. Now, what is the second question? Determine the amount of carbon dioxide gas released per liter of water. What we have studied is 1 mg per liter of filter alum liberates 0.396 mg per liter of carbon dioxide. So, we will use it this 1 mg per liter of filter alum. Filter alum liberates 0.396 mg per liter of carbon dioxide. So, we have been given how much? We have been given the dosage as 14 mg per liter. So, how much 14 mg per liter of filter alum will liberate carbon dioxide? 14 mg per liter of filter alum liberates 0.396 into 14. Which will give us as 5.544 mg per liter of carbon dioxide. It hasn't asked us the total amount of carbon dioxide liberated. Remember it, don't get confused. It has asked it per liter of water. That's why we calculated in per liter of water. If it would have asked in the question the total quantity of carbon dioxide generated, then what would we have done? We would have multiplied it by the total amount of water, that is the 12 mld of water. But here it has asked us in 1 liter. So, in 1 liter, 5.544 mg of carbon dioxide is liberated. So, we have solved two questions. Likewise, you can practice more number of questions. The most important thing is you have to remember this while solving the questions. If you remember this, definitely you will be able to solve the questions. Last thing which we will be dealing in alum is the advantages and the disadvantages part. What is there in advantages is, when you are coming to the advantages part, what you can see that it removes color, odor and bad taste. Similarly, it is very much economical also. It is economical. However, and the flock is produced at a rapid rate. The flock, jo humne dekha aluminium hydroxide, is produced at a rapid rate. These are the advantages. बट द डिसएडवांटेजेस इज जब हमने देखा कि एलम जब रिएक्ट करता है कैल्शियम हाइड्रोजन कार्बोनेट के साथ बाइकार्बोनेट एल्किनिटी के साथ तो उसमें क्या प्रोड्यूस होता है कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड प्रोड्यूस होता है. कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड से क्या होता है कोरोजन होता है पाइपलाइंस का. तो डिसएडवांटेज क्या है ड्यू टू कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड कोरोजन होता है पाइपलाइंस का कोरोजन ऑफ पाइपलाइंस. सिमिलरली कैल्शियम सल्फेट प्रोड्यूस होता है एलम के ट्रीटमेंट में जब वाटर के साथ ट्रीट करते हैं तो परमानेंट हार्डनेस भी मिलती है हमको. परमानेंट हार्डनेस दैट इज कैल्शियम सल्फेट. परमानेंट हार्डनेस इन द फॉर्म ऑफ कैल्शियम सल्फेट इज ऑब्टेन्ड जो कि हमारे लिए अच्छा नहीं है. थर्ड इज जब लार्ज अमाउंट ऑफ फ्लॉक प्रोड्यूस होता है तो ये तो हमारे लिए अच्छा है. जब फ्लॉक प्रोड्यूस होगा तो कोगुलेशन अच्छे से होगा हमको एडिशनल मिक्सिंग टैंक्स में उसको नहीं ले जाना पड़ेगा. बट द थिंग इज अगर लार्ज अमाउंट में रैपिड रेट में फ्लॉक प्रोड्यूस होगा तो जब हम इसमें के बाद फिल्ट्रेशन पड़ेंगे तो जो फिल्टर्स हम लोग यूज़ करते हैं उसके मैकेनिज्म को ये हिंडर करता है अगर लार्ज अमाउंट में फ्लॉक प्रोड्यूस होता है. तो इसके कुछ एडवांटेजेस भी हैं और इसके कुछ डिसएडवांटेजेस भी है. सो टुडे वी कंप्लीटेड द एलम वी सॉल्व द न्यूमेरिकल्स वी डिराइव्ड ऑल द नेसेसरी इन्फ्रेंसेज फ्रॉम द केमिकल फॉर्मुलाज एंड द रिएक्शंस. इन द नेक्स्ट लेक्चर वील बी डीलिंग रिगार्डिंग द मिक्सिंग टैंक्स इन कोगुलेशन पार्ट एंड वील बी डीलिंग मेनी न्यूमेरिकल्स मोर रिगार्डिंग द मीन टेम्पोरल वेलोसिटी ग्रेडियंट्स एंड मच मोर थिंग्स. सो आई होप यू enjoy today's class. Thank you.